Hey boys and girls, I'm Rhino. Welcome to the Chef Pastu. Today we're talking about the gluten-free diet, and I'm going to try to do it in an expedited way. Imagine for a moment that you love oranges, and that's how you get all of your vitamin C. And one day, they tell you, we will make you cheaper oranges, we will make you more oranges, and they will taste better. And you think, that is an excellent plan. And you start eating these new oranges, and then you start feeling kind of sick. And they say, oh, well, you know, in order to make the oranges better, we had to take out that vitamin C crap. Well, if that was your only way to get vitamin C, you will now get scurvy, like a pirate, and die. Gluten. If you're thinking about the gluten-free diet, and you've seen the amazing results people have had, well, a lot of those results come from people not eating as much processed, refined foods. And that's because a lot of the junk food out there has gluten in it. A lot of the junk food is cakes and cookies and muffins and pastas and breads and all of these things that, well, they have refined sugar and they're all processed. And if you stop eating all of that and start eating a lot of fruits and vegetables, yeah, of course you're gonna feel better and lose weight. Duh. But for a lot of us out there, we are noticing an increase in the amount of gluten intolerance and gluten sensitivity. If you think you're on the borderline of one of those things, it's definitely something to ask a physician about, and not YouTube. But I'm here to inform you about what gluten actually is. And it's a protein that exists in the wheat plant. It makes the plant hardy and more tolerant to inclement weather, as well as allowing it to be harvested sooner. When people figured this out hundreds of years ago, they bred as much gluten into that plant as possible without even really knowing what it was at the time. They crossbred it with grass, goat grass, but grass, and it genetically changed it. So I'm not saying to avoid gluten, I'm saying avoid genetically modified organisms, GMOs. You've probably heard about it all the time. Modern day wheat is a GMO. In ancient wheat, like Einkorn, that has been around, we think, for at least 1,000 years, is how wheat used to be. It is genome A. Modern wheat is genome D. The difference is in the four main substances of that wheat. You've got two proteins, gluten and gliadin. Now, in the ancient form of it, you had an abundance, a 2-to-1 ratio, of gliadin to gluten, because gliadin had the higher nutrient value. You could get things like rhiboflavin, retinol, beta-carotene, phosphorus, potassium. Gluten had very little of that. So, of course, we switched it, because why have nutrients? Let's have scurvy! Yay! And then the other two substances in wheat are starches. You have amylose and amylopectin A. Amylose was the 75% versus the 25% of amylopectin A, because amylose is better for digestion. It digests slowly, giving you long-lasting energy, meaning you feel full longer, versus the amylopectin A, which spikes your blood sugar, overproducing insulin, because it digests too quickly. So, of course, that got switched as well, because why not ruin a good thing? So when you're thinking about giving up gluten, think about going to ancient grains like quinoa and quinoa-based things like this quinoa-based pasta. It also has the non-GMO stamp on it. That's pretty important because we're trying to avoid genetically modified organisms. Now, quinoa is great in nutrients and protein. You don't have to eat it as pasta. You can eat it as it regularly comes, kind of like rice. When you're thinking about going gluten-free, think about going flourless. I have great recipes for brownies, cookies, pancakes, all totally flourless with no substitutes. You can really branch out and find new foods. I mean, sit down and think of how many different vegetables you eat and then try to double it, because there are some vegetables out there that are just a lot better than others. Now, you might also want to look into the pesticide theory, because pesticides are not good for us, something like BT toxin, which we spray on our wheat, can actually be bad for your kidneys. There is some research on that, so I would definitely look that up. As well as the Huffington Post mentioned, it's funny when I think about it, that bread could be addictive because of something called gluten morphine that they put into the wheat. I would totally believe that, but I haven't researched enough to know whether or not it is true. Always do your homework, kids. Now, you may have heard the rumor that it is easier to eat bread in Europe, and that is because most European countries allow less genetic modification and use less harmful pesticides and herbicides. Yep. Thanks for watching Chef Pursue. I hope you learned something. Don't forget to ask me any questions that you might have. Don't forget to subscribe and watch me next time. We'll be doing flourless chocolate torts.